right, breaking news coming in India today is Sahil Joshi has spoken to one of the independent MLAs who withdrew support to the Kumaraswamy government. The independent MLA Nagesh says what Congress is alleging is baseless. He also added that he is in Mumbai as last time Congress had captured him by force. He also said there is no coordination in the Congress JDS government and so we are withdrawing support. He in fact went on to say there are some Congress MLAs too who are discontent. So Nagesh making some explosive claims, says that he gave support to the Congress as he was picked up. He was in fact taken by force onto the Congress side. That is why he had to fled to Mumbai. Listen in to what Sahil Joshi's conversation with Nagesh went like.
The first question is about what exactly is the problem with the Congress JDS government.
There is no understanding between the coalition partners, mainly.
The Congress basically saying that, both of you are compromised because the BJP tried to put pressure, use the money power, and that's why you are hiding in Mumbai. That is what is the Congress.
I don't agree.
Then why are you here in Mumbai? I mean, why don't you go to governor and give your resignation yourself?
Yeah. It will go through mail now. It's already signed and given it to media. They've already taken the copy of that. By this time, it will go to governor's notice.
But when are you going to go to Bangalore and meet governor personally?
Now, I have to discuss with our senior leaders from Congress, those who are willing to come out of the Congress now.
Okay.
The team is getting ready. So I'll take the consent, then we'll go. Micro consent.
Who all Congress leaders are there with you at this point of time? Which Congress MLAs are going to come with you and take back support?
We are only 2 years. The other people, they are in different place. I have no idea about the numbers and the names.
So Mr. Ramesh, people are saying that he's leading the whole...
Yes. Yes, exactly right.
Okay. When are you going to Bangalore now?
Probably tomorrow
you'll be going to Bangalore.
I'll be after.
Thank you very much for speaking to India Today, sir. And will you be speaking on camera as well?
No, it's already spoken before the camera. Too much is too bad. I conveyed my feelings to the government, people of Karnataka. Okay, I'll go with the BJP.
Okay.
That is my final decision.
But then Congress is saying that why are you hiding? If you think that, why don't you come out in open and go to Bangalore and...
Open, they'll catch and keep me inside like last time what they did. Before counting is over, one minister had come. He picked me from the counting center, taken to governor's office. What they did, they're not respected and not recognized. Nothing they've done.
So now that's why you are hiding with the BJP leader.
It's not a question of hiding. It's better to be away from... for unnecessary fight or interaction.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Nagesh, for speaking to us. Mr. Shankar is...
Okay, Sahil Joshi joins us now. Sahil got us an exclusive conversation with the MLA who, in fact, is in Mumbai. Sahil, very pertinent question you asked him, and it was an interesting reply. Why is he hiding if he feels that, he is disillusioned by the Congress JDS government?
Absolutely. In fact, that is something which I was not expecting when he said that, last time that the Congress actually captured him, he was taken into custody kind of a thing and taken to Bangalore till the time he did not support the Congress JDS government. And that is the reason why now he's hiding here. But the second most important thing, he admitted that Ramesh Jharkiholi is the one who is actually leading all these MLAs who have revolted against Congress. He did not come up with the exact number of Congress MLAs, but he did say that, yes, the leaders of Congress will decide when to come out and go with the BJP directly, and then the rest of the things will be happening. But till then, it's likely that he will be stay put in Mumbai because he fears that if he goes to Bangalore, he will be recaptured by the Congress, and that's why that is of course his claim is at this point of time. But yes, he accepted that Ramesh Jharkiholi is the leader of these rebel group,
right,
and he's the one who will be taking decision regarding when to come out and support the BJP government out in open.
Sahil, also, then it is interesting, if the Congress at that point of time could in fact hold him hostage, should we not then insinuate right now that the BJP is holding him hostage?
Yeah, exactly. And that is what my question is, was to him. But he said that no, he is here because he feared that the Congress will hold him hostage. And that is the reason why he has come to Mumbai. And of course, I mean, he did say that the Congress MLAs are not in the hotel in which he has been kept. But the Congress MLAs are somewhere else. But our correspondent, Saurabh, who was inside the hotel, could claim that some of the Congress MLAs, including Ramesh Jharkhand, before these independent MLAs come out and sent a letter to the governor of Karnataka saying that they are withdrawing support from the Congress JDS government. So, you know, it is every minute this whole situation is turning into some different mode altogether, and we have to really keep a close watch because
absolutely.
The senior minister coming out and clearly saying to Kamlesh Sutar that yes, they are BJP is going to form the government in next 2-3 days. It clearly shows that the BJP is definitely involved in this whole drama. And of course, without their help, these MLAs wouldn't have dared to come out and said that they are coming out of Congress JDS government.
All right, Sahil, stay on with me. In fact, very interesting things which are happening right now in Karnataka. Interesting politically to see, but the brazenness and absolute no regard to political mandate, morality, it just seems hunger for power. The Nataka in Karnataka has exploded. And the two-day-long political drama took a twist after two independent MLAs, both of them in Mumbai, who one of them spoke to Sahil Joshi as well, withdrew support from the Congress JDS Alliance. H. Nagesh and R. Shankar. R. Shankar, remember, is known as Pendulum Shankar because he kept swinging between the BJP and the Congress camp just before the government formation 7 months back. They pulled out. That it now means that the HT Kumaraswamy government enjoys a wafer-thin majority in the Karnataka Assembly. The two independents have decided to back the BJP. However, a Maharashtra minister claimed that the BJP will form the government in Karnataka in the next 2 to 3 days. The fresh development comes hours after BJP leader Nilakamal Nagaraj was spotted meeting Congress and JDS MLAs pulled up inside a hotel in Mumbai. Meanwhile, the Congress has said there is no threat to the government after independence walked out.
Samisra Sarkarake Kutrita Kanta Bembalavana Ivato Navo Madhamada Mukantra Ivato Bembalavana Samisra Sarkara the Bembalavana Vapas Padita Dene Nano Sumaru ಆರೇಳು ತಿಂಗಳು ಮಂತ್ರಿಯಾಗಿ ತಾಲೂಕಿನ ಜನತೆಯ ಆಶೀರ್ವಾದದಿಂದ ಶಾಸಕನಾಗಿ ಸರ್ಕಾರದಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿ ತೃಪ್ತಿ ತಂದಿದೆ ಆದರೂ ಕೂಡ ಇನ್ನೂ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿನ ಕೆಲಸಗಳು ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ನಮಗೆ ಸರ್ಕಾರದಲ್ಲಿ ಸರಿಯಾದ ಸ್ಪಂದನೆ ಇಲ್ಲದ ಕಾರಣ ಇವತ್ತು ನಾನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಬೆಂಬಲವನ್ನು ಇವತ್ತು ವಾಪಸ್ ಪಡೆದು ಇವತ್ತು ಇನ್ನೂ
ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಪೆಂಡುಲಮ್ ಶಂಕರ್ Chief Minister Kumaraswamy, meanwhile, said that he had nothing to worry about after the withdrawal of the support by two independent MLAs. Listen in.
If two MLAs can create, you are free to that.
Sir, but they have given a letter.
Yes, see, what will going to happen? If two MLAs, independent MLAs, withdraw the support, what will be the numbers? I am totally relaxed. I in our Kannada channels going on from last 1 week. Yeah. I am enjoying it. They are in touch with me. Why do you worry?
Let's listen into what the Congress said on the current political drama in Karnataka.
See, we have been saying Bharatiya Janata Party is luring our MLAs with the money, with the power, and all kinds of things. So definitely, you know, they are trying their best to topple this government, which they are not going to be successful. Our government is stable.
But sir, with these withdrawals, how are you seeing this, sir? Nobody would say that if
so there are people. The, has come down.
The numbers are coming down, sir.
No. It's not a number. With me is Mr. K.C. Venugopal, Congress Karnataka in charge. Sir, how critical is the Karnataka government here? Because we have been hearing three MLAs in Mumbai, two in Delhi. Opposition are claiming that there's a threat.
This is a time of Sankranti festival. Everybody has the freedom to go there. Some worship places, some pilgrim places, some tourist places. They are going. Then why are you going to disturb them? But as far as the government stability is concerned, I am very much pretty clear that this government will continue.
Sir, and two of your independent MLAs who had supported you earlier have withdrawn support, saying that their concerns were not taken care of.
No, actually, we will look into it, definitely. They have every right to take a decision on their own because they are independent. No, definitely, they will look into their concern. I think they will also come back.
So we have seen visuals of Mr. Umesh Jadhav in Mumbai hotel with certain BJP leaders.
I am not denying the ugly horse trading efforts of BJP. Unfortunately, that is going to be celebrated. That is celebrating here all places. What is the necessity of keeping all the MLA in a resort? That is giving a clear message. They want to take ugly politics to destabilize this government.
They are saying why they have put their MLAs in the resort is because, starting from the chief minister, everyone is trying to poach their MLAs.
What is the necessity of here to poach the MLAs? We already given some evidence as last time also. They are talking to our MLAs, and what we never went behind them.
Will Congress also take this issue to the speaker about how the two MLAs have resigned? Maybe there is something external pressure also. Is this an angle that you are probing?
No, we are very much confident. We are very much confident that nothing is going to be happen. We are very much confident there is nothing going to happen. This government will continue.
So even if there is a no confidence motion in February, you are government?
Let them introduce their non-confidence motion. They have every right to do that. They have done it like that. They swear in for a chief minister for 2 days, and we prove it also.
So one final question, Mr. Ramesh.
The country is also witnessing, the national capital also witnessing how BJP is dealing with this type of politics.
So one final question, is Mr. Ramesh Jharkioli turned out to be your biggest headache in the last 2 months?
I don't want to tell any single name or any particular name, but we are very much confident no Congress MLA will leave.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.